Well, Jay, of course, has the diagnosis of autism. He also has ADHD, intellectual disability, which used to be called mental retardation, and apraxia. And so he has a significant level of need in terms of his daily care. You asked me what it's like as a parent to receive the diagnosis of autism. And of course, for many autistic children, it's between age 2 and 3. And probably I sort of use the analogy that it's like when you have a baby, a young baby, you see the whole future laid out in front of you like a highway. You see all the different scenarios. You see the house he's going to live in and his preschool friends and this preschool he goes to and the elementary school and our friends and even into middle school and high school and college and then even way off in the distance, you can kind of squint and see grandchildren. So you kind of look at it as if everything is fairly predictable and straightforward. And then when you receive the diagnosis of autism, it's like you're having car failure. You're a flat tire. You have to pull off by the side of the road. And you can't get the information you need. You can't see the future. Everything's overgrown in front of you. It's really unpredictable, and you don't know who to go to for help. And that type of thing. And so it really becomes a burden every day to determine what's the next step for your child once you receive that diagnosis. And in my case, it was fairly poignant because my relationship with my own father was non-existent. And here I was wanting to start a new cycle of father-son relationships that would carry on and prosper in the future that, for his children and certain generations down the road. We have another son too that we have his activities to deal with. So it's really a day every morning where you get up and you say, what's going to happen today? And we have a written schedule and we have programs and we have contacts and we have people to deal with. And part of the challenge of having a team like that is the leadership you need to have to guide everybody along on the same page. Well, a typical day for Jay, now that he's 24, we have a home program where we have five individuals come to our house all through the week, 7 days a week, to involve him in different programs and things. And what we particularly enjoy is trying to find new things for him to do in order to see a side of him we hadn't seen before. For instance, we started very young when he was riding horses. And we always thought, well, he'll be a kid that gets led around the ring by a trainer. And, he's just able to just ride the horse. That's a big step. And that's probably all he'll be able to do. But through different people and different instructors through the years and trying different places to go to, he's able to actually ride the horse himself and canter and do different things that we thought were not possible. And so that's the challenge is every day is how far can we push him? And how far can we take him? And most recently, he's been working. He has certain skills we would call splinter skills, like he can read, for instance. He's very good at the computer, and he's very good at following steps that are written down. His most current job is working, doing scanning work for medical records division here at the local college. And he's able to do very, very well because it's a very methodical step-by-step process. But through the efforts of a team and getting outside input, we're able to persevere and enable him to have that independence, which he so desperately needs in order to continue on in life.